is Annabelle Duncan, and the name of my company is Be His, Blessed Hands Interpreting Services. Blessed Hands Interpreting Services is a company based on the foundation of my mom and dad. God gave me the vision to develop and create an organization that would provide interpreting services. When the interpreting profession began, I was a young girl, so I'm really telling my age a little bit. And there was not very many interpreters, so my older brother and I had to be our parents' interpreter. And so growing up doing that on a regular basis and just seeing how the deaf community was being treated during that time, as I got older, I didn't realize that that's something that I wanted to do. And when the opportunity was presented to me, I took advantage of it and I developed Blessed Hands. It was in another name at that time. And then years later, the Lord gave me the idea to change the name. I changed the name to BHIS, Blessed Hands Interpreting Services, and we sometimes call it Be His. This company will empower companies to understand, know what is required if they want to conduct business with a deaf and hard of hearing or deaf blind person and vice versa. We want to ensure that there are quality interpreters, but most importantly, we are pro accessibility. The main point for Blessed Hands Interpreting Services is to make sure that the deaf person has accessibility, because when I was growing up, my parents didn't have that. And it was very important because they want to conduct business. They're consumers and they spend money just like anybody else. So you want to make sure that you give them the opportunity to be able to go open a bank account, to go on a job interview, to be able to do things that everybody else does. Well, first I'd like to thank Great Lakes for the nomination and honoring me with this award. I'm very thankful and grateful for that. What it means, you know, it took me a minute to think about, okay, because when you see something, it may not, it resonates, but you're trying to figure out how. And so one day it just occurred to me, I was like, wow, I am a leader. And I recalled a situation in my own company where I brought somebody on board and I was able to help them grow in the area of interpreting. And also I have a nonprofit. So being a leader in that aspect, helping the deaf, connecting them to resources and services. And then we also did a lot of fundraising. And so we would go to the different sporting events and raise money by working the concessions. And being able to lead that and be a leader to empower the deaf to go out there, serve these customers, communicate in sign language. They have to meet you where you are, not the other way around. Exercising and staying healthy. And I bought a bike just recently from a garage sale. So my grandson and I went bike riding yesterday, and I was like, back when I was 10, 11, 12 years old, when I would ride my bike like it was my car. So it felt very exhilarating to ride my bike yesterday. But it wasn't until I got home and settled down that whatever stress that was trying to get to me that day was totally gone. So I'm gonna be riding my bike a little bit more often. I wanna thank Leslie Gamage for taking the time out to come and to interpret for me. She's a friend and I appreciate her supporting me in this endeavor. And I wanna thank Great Lakes, and also wanna thank my family. I wanna thank God, but I also wanna thank Tony Ferris for making the nomination on my behalf.